Hi everyone, this is Harriet Claire. I'm here at the Home Depot. And this is a dwarf navel orange Washington. I would love to have it. But I now have so many other plants on my balcony that adding any more at this time. I just purchased this one about a month ago. And it is doing well. And that's a Satsuma. And I hope it is a dwarf. I'm not quite sure. But right now, I have it in the community garden so it can grow. There's mostly lime out here. This one looks interesting in terms of it is thornless. And I don't know why I'm into that, but I would prefer to have something thorn. Oh, this one has an apple on it. Oh my God. Look at this. You see that? What is this? This is an Asian citrus. I believe that's what I was hearing about on Lead Farmers. I'm not quite sure, but there it is. But I'm not in the market for that today. I'm really not. Here's a Chinese jujube. I can't tell how much it is. Someone has kind of scratched it off down there. But this is basically what's out here. It's nothing but lemons. Meyer lemons, which I already have. And she blooms every year for me. I did buy it from here. I also like to go to Lowe's. Here's a tangerine. A lot of lemons, a lot of limes. There are no vegetables, and I couldn't even find the seeds today when I came in. So again, not very many fruits, trees, a lemon over here. I believe this is a lime. I'm coming up on a lime right here. Here's a pear. This is the only pear that I saw here. And it's called a 20th century. I don't know what that is. Here's a dwarf mandarin clementine. So, there's a key lime right over there. Here's a pineapple guava bush. All of them are running between $34 to $39. But I am here to pick up some soil. So as I walk back, hi, I will show you some of the things that I have in my garden. But I am really here for the soil. So again, I'm at Home Depot, and I try to buy some of these smart plants to put on my balcony because they attract the butterflies. Even sometimes I get occasional some bees that stop, but I get butterflies and I get the hummingbirds. And as you can see here, everything looks pretty. But there are no seeds for me to grow vegetables at all. It's all pretty flowers. And I decided a long time ago, because of my limited space, that I would somewhat limit the type of flower that I would have, because I need to be able to plant the food. So here's where they have the container gardening soil. Um, This is for the raised bed. And then they have container soil here. And I'll show you the prices so that you can see. They have some over there too. But one of the things that I really wanted to share with you all was the type of soil that I use to plant my vegetables in. I have tried just about every single one that's here. I also buy this particular brand at Lowe's. And right here is the price for this one. I used to buy bigger ones, but now I stick with this. So remember, when I planted my garden, I tested everything that was out here. And the most successful soil, potting soil, that I have been able to use that will grow vegetables on my balcony, which is shaded, is this one. And that's Kellogg's Organic Patio Plus. So keep that in mind if you're starting your garden out on your balcony, in a small space, and you're doing it in a container. You may have to check and see which of the soils works best for you, but for my zone 10, this is what works best. And if you remember what my collards look like, my collards have been planted in this particular brand from the very beginning. And my collards are now 3 years old and they keep producing for me. I always get more leaves. And my family found out that they are very delicious. They're very tender. And they have encouraged me to keep going because I had considered stopping because I leave my garden to the care of others so much of the time. I want to thank you and let you know that I really appreciate you watching me. And God loves you, and so do I. Have a wonderful day.